Hey yo guys, so in this video I'll be showing you exactly how to trade with a full-time job and become profitable over time. So if you follow these steps, you're sure and guaranteed be on your step to making success in trading. So I've been trading for a few years now and I was also in the same position where I had a full-time job, but I was able to quit it after 4 years of trading. And then I'll be showing you these exact strategies that you can use if you have a full-time job to start making money and eventually leave your job. So don't forget to subscribe, guys, and don't forget to smash that like button as I bring more of these videos to help you out as a full-time trader or as a part-time trader. All right, so let's go right into the video, guys.
So guys, the first step is make sure you plan your charts. So you know, if you're obviously working, so you need to make sure that at least before, during the weekend is when you do analysis. That's probably the most important thing for you as you are still trying to get out of obviously your job and stuff like that. So weekends are actually good to actually look at what you're going to be trading during the week. I still do this myself because this helps me that when the week comes, when I start trading, all I have to do is to basically look at my setup and I enter. Literally that's it. Imagine you just finished during the weekend and then during at work and then you look at your analysis, or you're like, okay, I'm waiting for my trade to hit this point and then I'm gonna be looking to enter. So for example, you can just take even like 10 minutes look at your chart. Has it reached this level? If not, you wait. If yes, then you execute it. Why? Because you plan during the weekend. Also, make sure you are consistent. So you wanna stick to the same thing that you keep doing over and over again. This is what helps you if you plan it during the weekend. And also an important thing is if you're doing this during the weekend, you're eliminating your emotions. So you need to always trade in a good mood. So if only you're looking for where you're going to enter, you should be in a good mood. Even when you enter a trade, make sure you only trade when you're in a good mood. So you're going to increase your win rates. That's the most important thing. And you'll only be doing that to enhance your trading. So plan before weekend, but if it happens that you obviously want to look at the charts during the week, it's good to do it like around your work. So for example, if you're trading during the day, then during the evening, you can start looking at your charts. Or if you're working at night, then you can, in the mornings, you can look at your charts. It's basically as simple as that. You need to plan beforehand. And what I'm talking about is your stop losses and your take profits. So during the week, have your pairs that you're looking at, and then we're gonna obviously start looking at what is gonna move your market after that. So you always wanna make sure it's at the correct time that is gonna work for you. Otherwise, you're gonna be wasting your time. Well, by doing that, you're eliminating all the stress, as I said, because if you don't see your setup, you don't trade. Otherwise, you're gonna be stressful if you, I'm looking for a trade, I'm looking for a trade. Remember, less is more with trading. All right, so let's move on to the next. The next step is basically to trade during the best Forex market hours. So what I mean by this is you wanna look at high volatility movements. So when the market is actually moving. So these are usually London sessions and New York sessions. Why I'm saying this is because the spreads at this time or these times, they are very low. So basically per trade, it's not costing you a lot. So, and then you're gonna actually see more movements most of the time. And the other strategy also is to trade when your pair is moving. Okay, so obviously you're gonna check when my specific pair is moving. Otherwise, you're just gonna wait for it while it's just not moving. So make sure you focus on when it's actually moving, okay? I would actually try to avoid news, but I'm talking about general, look at your London sessions or whichever sessions, Asian sessions, and then focus on that for that specific pair. So let's go for one example. So for example, let's say I'm trading EURUSD. I'd set my time to trade it at 8. My trading will start at 8 a.m. to 11 a.m. EST. All right. So that's basically my sessions if I'll be trading the EURUSD. And then that's when you know the market will move well, and then usually less spreads, less cost to you, and you're actually going to catch good movements. So remember, the main point is to alleviate the stress and make sure you're trading when it's actually moving. This is why I don't trade a lot But I just wait for my market, as I said, step one, and then I trade when it actually moves. Right, I hope this actually helps you. Right, so just look for the specific pair and focus on that pair. Step number three, look at the best trading strategy according to your schedule. Right, so for example, if I'm working a full-time job, I don't really have a lot of time. I'll rather focus on intra-trading or swing trading. So I don't have to keep looking at the charts the whole time. So this is actually what I used to do. Like I used to look at like 4 hour time frame, even 1 hour time frame, and swing my trades and do also also intra-trading. Right, so I had maybe during, when I had lunch, maybe I used like 1 hour just to check, has my market gone to where I want it, and just make sure it's the risk is accordingly, and maybe I adjusted my stop losses and all of that. See, I only had a bit of time with that. So for example, if I'm trading a 4 hour, and then I'll wait after what, 8 hours to check where my trade is. Okay, but if you do have time, if you, for example, you have more time in your work, you rather do scalping. So you basically trade between like 30 minute time frame or 15 minute time frame. But day traders, for me, it's not my preference, okay? Because it can bring a lot of stress to you. But if you do have that capacity, it's a good thing. It just depends on your personality. Right, so these are just, so look at what your schedule allows you and what you prefer to do, right? All right, so step number four, continue to improve your trading skills, guys. This is very important. So even as myself, I still continue to work on myself. So keep learning and just have a journal or weekly performance and see what you did wrong and what you can improve on. Remember, to become a good trader, you need to really know and keep learning and improving yourself, especially your mindset and stuff like that. So check where you went wrong. There's always something to be improved. Remember, the best traders are always learning. So even myself, as I said, I continue learning, and what I learn, obviously, I show others too. So keep learning. There are also trading books you can do, and keep learning that. But one tip I can say, don't be jumping over. For example, if I'm learning on YouTube, I'm going to this video, going to this video. So rather you stick on one thing and keep learning on it. So if I have a strategy, I need to perfect the strategy, not jumping from one place to another. That's going to ruin your trading. As much as you're learning continuously, but you're bombarding yourself, you're literally confusing yourself. So you want to focus on one thing that keeps working and keep focus on improving it and become good at it, right? That's the best thing you can do for yourself, right? So that's the fourth tip. If you have a trading mentor, then you can literally just keep doing the same thing that they show you. So thereby improving yourself. This is why I usually say, yeah, people who learn from others, they can learn quicker. Obviously, depending on who the mentor is. Some are not really genuine and they won't really teach you as much. So you end up just wasting your time. So you really want to focus on one thing that will really help you. Otherwise, if you're just skipping and then you think, oh, this is going to help you, you're wrong, literally, as I keep telling you. Before I started trading, I really wanted to have a good mentor, but as you know, people are not really genuine out there. So yeah, I ended up not taking more time to learn. But imagine if you have a mentor and you just keep doing the same thing, ask them questions, keep doing the same thing over and over again. This is exactly what I do with my students. If they have any questions, I always like, I'm there to help support them, just because I didn't have someone to support me when I had my trading journey. That's literally what you could do. Just keep learning from someone who knows and keep improving yourself. That's one of the foolproof ways to make money with forex trading and improve your skill. Not the least, the final step is that you need to be consistent. So everything you do, you need to just keep doing the same thing. So it basically comes down to, are you doing the right thing? Guys, I hope this was helpful, and I hope it'll help improve your trading just like it helped me. And yeah, if you have any questions and you have anything you want to ask me, I'm more than happy to answer you. If you did enjoy the video, don't forget to smash the like button. Also, don't forget to subscribe. We're bringing you more videos of how to make money and become a full-time trader, a profitable trader just like me. And who knows, maybe travel the world like me. But anyway, just do anything you want to do. All right, so if you do also want my free signals where I have a huge win rate of 60% or more, I'll put the link in the description down below. Other than that, I hope you can enjoy my videos and keep learning from me and keep making money on. Right, so guys, see you on Monday's video, guys. Let's go.